Okay, we were on tying two ropes together. Let's now make a loop. Let's make a loop out of these two ends. So I have this relatively small piece of paracord here, and I'm going to show you two ways to do this. Okay, number one is this. I'm going to go and do a fisherman's knot. Okay, so here's my two ends, and they're overlapped. This side is going to go, and I'm going to make a loop. Once I've created that loop, I'm going to take the end and I'm going to put it back and through along the length of the rope. Okay, so that's what that looks like. Halfway done. I'm going to do the exact same thing over here. So I make a loop, and then this end goes back through the opposite way. Now I have like two pretzels. Pop those babies together. There's one way to do this. Okay. Another way to do this, and this is not as good of a way because this is super easy to untie. It's also super strong. The other way to do it, and this is like old school, just very, very simple. Literally, just do this. Right, like a straight up overhand knot. Now I just used both pieces of the rope to do that. And if you do that, it's slightly more permanent. This is kind of hard to untie, so you might not want to tighten on that. But it is something you can do if you wanted to make a bunch of permanent loops. This would be a great way to do it. Okay, I'm going to go back to my fisherman's knot here because I quite enjoy that one. That's a good knot to know. Hopefully this is visible enough. You can see my hands moving, and I'm trying to move out of the way to get this done for you. There we go. Pull on it. Now I have a loop. Okay, I'm going to do a Prusik knot. A Prusik knot is a climbing knot, but it can be used in many different ways. Okay, so I start with my loop over top. This is my ridge line. I tied this up earlier. And I'm going to take the knotted piece, and I'm going to go through my top part. Now it looks like this. I'm going to do that again. Through. And you'll notice we're getting these lines. I'm going to go one more time. There we go. Now I'm going to pull this down. Let's get this separated for you to see. I'm going to pull this down, and I'm going to kind of bring these together, because the beauty of the Prusik knot is that these wraps, and there should be three distinct wraps, just like this. I can twist it to kind of get it to tighten. Dress it so it looks good. Squish it together. There we go. So now I have 1, 2, 3 wraps on one side, and 1, 2, 3 wraps on the other side. You could just do two. I think three is just a little stronger. So there's my Prusik loop. Now, why the hell would I do this? This is going to be really handy when I go to tie up my tarp. So let's say I have webbing on the corners of my tarp. So just a little piece of that sort of web material that kind of comes out and makes a loop. Okay, so I could take this and put it through that loop, and then I could take a branch and I could lock that off. And then when I go to pull this, this actually will tension upon sliding. So you can see that there's no tension on this side, so it slides really easy. It's a beauty, okay? Now I take it here, I pull it sideways, and it's not going anywhere. It's locked in on itself. So what I can do is I have this through the webbing hole, this toggle, so it's being held, and then I can pull this over to tighten, right? Ba-boom, you got something that's adjustable in terms of tension, which is deadly. super cool, easy to tie, and it's not going anywhere, right? As soon as you get that toggle through there, it's locked onto itself. So your tarp is going to stay taut. Not only that, if you don't want it to be quite so taut, you just come over and adjust it. Oh man, that's a beauty right there. That is so good. So there's a Prusik loop. Now check this out. This is my favorite part of the Prusik loop. You just pull, and it literally just unwinds itself, and then it's untied. So good. That's a great knot for you to know and practice.
Yeah.